deciding what to do on the field, I'm not gonna call. I mean, I see doing this ace high. Would ace high like bet here for value or something? I'd rather fold. I'd rather fold and not find out. I'll definitely have the opportunity to call him a little bit lighter some spots and just to see see what he's up to in hands like this. Definitely don't need to push it for every price for our. Let's bet here. Alex is definitely gonna call, of course. Yeah, I'm gonna call with against diamonds. Just defending when the ace deuce. He donk bets. I'll fold because I have no idea what Luanta's gonna do behind me. So raising a cap by Aruktart. I'm gonna be greedy little bastard once again. Just gonna go for a call and raise the turn. I mean, obviously I'm hoping that he would continue with a bet on the turn. Jack 9. Yes, let's raise. Let's hope the freaky weirdo folds and I'm gonna be heads up against GG. And that's exactly what happened. Nice. And he actually donk bets. Not that nice anymore, but he, the last time he donk bet, he actually donk bet with a queen 4. And I think I just out-turned him here. I didn't out-flop him, I out-turned him. And he just folds, so I guess he was bluffing once again. Well, that's good to know. I'm up 100 bucks, guys. Hold the manager updated itself. I assume it was during one of the note-making minutes. Against El Greco, I'm gonna check behind because I think he's gonna be checking behind a lot here as well. He's gonna be checking a lot of the rivers anyway, so I'm gonna be seeing the river for free or the showdown for free. And here is the showdown for free, and he has a jack. So yeah. Cool bananas is back, guys. Cool bananas is back. Gonna call once. I'm kind of hoping he's gonna check, and he does. Nice. So I can see again the river for free, but I'm not gonna call this time. This time I'm gonna fold. So now I'm back to just see how swingy is. In one session, I went from being up, well, 93 bucks, I guess, to being down. Being down how much, like 20, so I lost 113 bucks at some point of this today's session, and then I won back. I went back to being up 100 bucks. So yeah, definitely swingy. I'm gonna go once with my with my gacha here. Funny Baker. Yeah, I'll definitely call once. Again, only have a gut shot. And diamonds even don't bet. I was even surprised that diamond didn't don't bet on the flop. Yes, I did 20 from 20 to 700 in 40 days. I think it was even less than that, to be honest. But yeah, after that, it just going up and down, up and down. I mean, technically, I actually finished with the challenge already. If I count the whole rake back, or if you want to call it stars coins now, if I count the stars coins in, I can turn stars coins into cash money, into cash bonus. And if I'm considering all that, I'm done. I was done in the session. I was done with the challenge a while ago, but I kind of decided that I'm gonna try to do it the proper way. With winning the money on the tables. I mean, that was still, I decided that when I was still doing, when I was just running hot. I was running so hard that I said, oh, you know what, guys, let's not count reg back into it anymore just because it's going way too well and we're gonna finish too fast. And now here I am, 60 days or 70 days later, still grinding the 1-2. So Georgie didn't bet, so he's not gonna be inducible, so he's like the same as El Greco, seems like the same player as El Greco. Even though El Greco actually check raised or check 3 bet before with a flush draw with ace 4 with a nut flush draw. Maybe it was even a straight flush, I don't remember. Or maybe it was a straight plus a flush, I think that was the case. And an ace, of course, you also had an ace. Diamond, no luck this time. And that's what I expect from a player like this, to be honest, like to come to the tables and just do his buy and maybe then rebuy. But the last time he was here, he was just. He was crushing my soul. Crushing my soul. Currently, I have obviously have two emoticons. I'm just watching the PogChamp, the Nenonoko. I'm watching the Nenonoko here. Let's settle it in the chat. But yeah, I need like 20 subscribers in order to actually get more to get more emoticons, I think. So I'm still long way to go for that. My here was I thought he was gonna dunk bet if he actually has something here on the river, if he has an 8. I mean, even if he doesn't, he only has $1 left, so I guess I would make a bad bet for $1, so that's fine. But he didn't bet when he actually flopped the top pair. So he dunk bets twice for now, and he was bluffing in both instances. I mean, I actually saw the hand once, but the second time he actually folded right away, so I assume he was bluffing in that case as well. But now he actually hit the top pair. He didn't do anything about it. He just called down. He didn't even put that $1 that he had left in, even though it was a perfectly fine hand for him, it seemed. Oh, I guess that was an ace. Maybe, I guess. I guess I understand then, but I don't know. I can't expect him when he's flop. Maybe he would do something about it if ace wouldn't hit on the turn. So he was kind of like check calling the flop with the nuts, right? With the top pair, and he was willing to do something on the turn instead. But I guess he just either there was an ace and he just switched the strategy or switched the thinking on that point. The graph looks just crazy. Like going up and going slowly down till the minus 20 or whatever it was, now just going straight up to 100. Just gonna call. I'm gonna raise right away. Both these guys calls, I mean, the Aruktard call is not surprising, let's say like that, but El Greco calling, it's a little bit worrying. He cold calls too here on the flop. I'm willing to bet again, of course, with my 8s, even though the 10 is not like something that I really want to see, but ooh, he actually raised now. Okay, now I'm just calling, I'm folding the turn. Folding the river, I mean, I'm gonna call, of course, I still have an 8. You managed to lose $20 in 20 minutes. Well, when I started with $20 on 5s and 10 cents, that's only like 20 big bets, of course. So I was saying to myself, if I lose that, I'm willing to redeposit, I guess. I kind of made a min deposit, so I think $20 was a min deposit on PokerStars, so I kind of made like a min deposit or something. So I said, I know that I'm playing with 200 big bets, which is pretty aggressive, and if I lose that's not a problem. I'm gonna just gonna do a rebuy or redeposit and just gonna go from there. Which fold? So I'm gonna play for another hour and like 50 minutes, something like that. I probably should make one small break, in a few minutes. Like the tables are so good, I don't want to quit right now because the tables are so fucking great. King Queen. Yeah, we need to see bet. Sure, why not against these two guys? I mean, call by someone who's kind of loose and aggressive is going to be interesting to see what he has. Like, people usually have like their small pairs or some suited hands or like ace deuce. I mean, yeah, that's also suited hand, of course, but yeah, something like that. I'm just gonna bet out like I'm presenting an ace here. I'm hoping he folds pair of fours or something. Okay, he had ace 10 and just raised the flop. So that was a little bit of a fail, but I don't think he played that well on the flop. I mean, just obviously he played against my range perfectly, but not sure what he actually meant there with that raise. I mean, he did like raise my opening range from the undergun, which is going to be, of course, the strongest of all. Cool bananas. I'm gonna call once again and just fall and improved. And here is not an improvement, and like I said, I'm gonna fold. Jack 8, unfortunately, hit at 8 on the turn. So be it. So be it, Mazzola from Germany. Let's race against Freaky Weirdo. He's not falling that much as he did before. So I guess that those stats just didn't converge just yet. So I can put him on an orange color note. I think he's gonna just be a standard deck here on these tables. Not the greatest flop from my hand, of course. I was still calling with my backdoors, so now I can fold. Not play yourself. Yeah, I mean, that's why you have to do the bankroll management, just because even if you play perfectly, even if you do everything fine, which I guess maybe you just didn't in that case, who knows. Of course, can't really comment about your hair, just about the two lines here, but that's why we're doing the bankroll management, of course, because you never know, even you can play perfectly and still lose money on the tables. Five, seven, let's see what Diamonds does. Diamond calls, okay. I was hoping he would fold, I guess not. I'm raising here, of course, like I said many times before. I'm raising here because of my fold equity, but I guess I have none on ace, ace, queen board against diamonds. 3-bet by Alex, well, that's surprising. I have a gacha and backdoor flush. Choo-choo-choo-doom. Let's call once. And let's call the second time. I mean, my ace may be good. I mean, he wasn't really... I was trying to get him to bet before in some hand. I don't really recall what it was. I think he had like a king 9. I had like 9 deuce or something like that. And I flopped a pair of deuce. And he didn't bet. So maybe I shouldn't be calling here, to be honest. Tornado Dog. I don't know. He hit a king now. That king is definitely not going to be great for me. Let's see if any notes. Check raise top pair, jack turn. So he's check raising top pairs, but now he just bet out here. He had 5-8, holy shit. What did I have in this hand? Oh, I had ace-9. He had king-queen, so I guess my ace wasn't good, but still. I don't know, folding here, but I don't know, not sure what to do here. I mean, even if he bluffed here on the flop, like some of the draws definitely came in, unless like he was doing this with a the flush draw, so I'm gonna fold. I mean, folding a pair of jacks is nothing that I want to do regularly here on these limits, but so far I think I had pretty good reads on all these guys, so I'm pretty good decisions. So let's keep it that way. I guess now I'm not up 100 bucks anymore. I was gonna say like something like 50. Playing exactly for 3 hours. at how many hands? 921. So I actually haven't updated my graph for 120 hands already. Oh, I have no idea how I'm doing then. Let's fold A3. So maybe now I just play the blind here. Or maybe after the neck, you know what? Let's sit out next with blind here on this table. I'm gonna go on a quick 5-minute break, guys. And just play for another hour in these cash games. And after that, we're gonna again try to qualify for the $1 million free roll with that satellite once again. Okay, let's sit out here as well. I kind of wanted to check raise already on the flop, but decided not to do it against Cool Bananas. I don't know why, but it doesn't feel right. But now I can actually hit a top pair king and still have a pretty good draw here, even if I am behind here somehow. Ugh, did he really call with Ace X here? Nope, he didn't. Okay, but I can't see myself betting here into him. Sixes. Oh. He played well, of course. He played well, I just got a little bit unlucky. So am I sitting out on all these tables? I am, okay. Sevens on a 10-9-5. Doesn't sound that bad, but still two overcards. Nine is definitely a good card. And queen is definitely not a good card, so let's go for a check call instead. See at what? King 5. Oh, he hit a pair. So he played fine. He played fine as well. So let's play. Actually, see now. Let's play this hand when he's gonna be the blind here. Yes, let's play. Now let's sit out next hand now. Don't want to pay another blind in case someone quits here or something. That definitely happened before. Let's ice raise diamonds here. Obviously, I want to play against him as much as I can. He went for a limp raise. I have limp cap with king queen suited in notes. And he just raised the low flop in that case, so he actually did have a good hand the last time. Oh, he actually raised low flop means that he actually raised with king high. Whoa, okay, that's not that clear then, but I think obviously with a king 8 or whatever I had on ace xx board, I think it's gonna be fold anyway. Ace queen, right? Yes. So one more hand and then I'm gonna go on a 5-minute break, guys. Let me actually start the countdown counter here. 5 minutes, and let's play start. Let's also give you guys the break back in. And after the break, I'm actually tell you all about the free roll that we're gonna do. So yeah, I'll be back, guys, in 5 minutes. Just checking if I'm seen out, and I am. I'll be back, guys. And I am back, guys. So, made before the deadline. Nice. Sure. I want to tell you all about the free roll that I am doing in my home games. I know I have to this one. Let's wait 3 seconds because you know what? Let's not wait. Let's do it like this. Oh yeah. Everyone who is new here and hasn't joined my home games, well, you really should, because I'm doing a free roll on Saturday when I'm gonna be giving out a ticket for the 10th anniversary Sunday Million. So whoever wins the free roll is gonna get a ticket for Sunday Million, for the 10th anniversary Sunday Million, that it's happening this Sunday. So in 2 days, it's gonna be a, well, $10 million granted prize pool, as you can see here. And also I'm giving out 5 tickets to to all of you losers who's gonna finish in 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, and 6th place. So just giving the next 5 guys a ticket, Sunday Storm ticket as well. So you join in the home games by just entering all this ID and code, which is Limit Cat, of course. Like I said, the free roll is gonna be tomorrow, starting at 9 p.m. Central PM time. So let me just check the home games if anybody is new. Anybody new wants to join? Yes, there are some people who are new. Ofca and Demison from Croatia. So let's accept you guys. Welcome to the home games. And I had a best hand here. Nice with 8-7. I actually got lucky. So yeah, like I said, schedule tomorrow at 9 p.m. So that's what, in 21 hours and 30 minutes. Free roll with 54 entries so far. First place wins 10th anniversary Sunday Million ticket with 10 million guaranteed prize pool. And 5 Sunday Storm tickets are added for 2nd to 6th place. So for the next 5 guys, they're going to win Sunday Storm tickets. Like sort of a consolation prize if you can't get if you can't win the whole thing, the whole free roll. So yeah, and it's free and it's open to all. Well, it's not technically free, I guess you need 1.1 play money, but I think you can get play money at any point if you want. So it's essentially a free roll, but I know some people said no, it's not a free roll, but I guess technically they are correct. So let's continue. Someone quit here, but again, she seems to be like loose passive as well, so I don't mind that at all. I don't know who was here before, can't remember. And let's update the graph as well. Let's see how we're doing. Back in, back out. So I am up how much? $73. So yeah, I did fell to the $50 region before, so it's going really, really up and down really fast. So yeah, I'm still up 73, so definitely happy about that. So let's continue now. So I flopped the nuts. I'm gonna go for a check raise. Let's see if Agente is gonna be someone who's gonna, well, try to bet against me. So far, guess not. I guess I'll bet myself. And I wonder what he has. If he's checking behind like a 5 or 8. Nice, ace 3. That's pretty good call down. Nice. I mean, for me, of course. Not for Agente. Well, that's a dangerous turn, and I have 2 guys in. I'm actually gonna go for a check. No, come on, JNT, check behind. So that means I have the best hand, right? I mean, someone could still have a queen. I wouldn't be surprised if someone shows me queen 10 here. Wow, even raised by a JNT. Well, now I. Wow. I guess he has, I have no idea what he has. Maybe pair of threes. I mean pair of threes in this case would be a set. Yes, that's what he has. Unfortunately, he got lucky. That's fine. Maybe if we wait one more second for him to show that tongue of his, I guess I would fold. But man, he called me in a queen 9-5 board with a pair of threes, so I guess I can't really be angry about that. But yeah, he definitely got lucky there. I shouldn't start losing again. No. No. The 10. He actually makes a bet. I'll fold. I'll believe him. And yeah, thank you, Svetlo, for posting the home games info. It's also here, and you can see the in the bottom left as well, so it's all over the place, you can't miss it. One, two table, I don't really need it, but man, I'm gonna actually save this table for later because it's just such a good table. I think I can go for a check call, raise the turn. I guess not anymore, and I'm just hoping that he's bluffing here. Ugh, all this also Knight of Spades. I guess I'll lose the hand, but I can't really fault against this guy. He had ace 8-7. Holy shit. So he is gonna be a little tricky pony. When he flops something, he's just check calling down. That's fine for him, but when he has nothing, he's gonna be, well, a little tricky bluffy pony. And it's fine, we're just gonna call him down. The problem is that if that queen wouldn't hit, I guess, I mean, I would raise the turn and he would just fold, I assume, so I guess that queen on the turn kind of made me a little, like, $2 more out of his hand. So it was good turn for me. This time he actually had a flush, and I would bet you that he didn't. he just don't bet the, that's fine. He just called, I thought he had a flush draw already on the flop, but I see he just got a runaround flush. That's fine. Doesn't matter then. The reads are real. Yeah, so, GG, I just want to say something about that, about your hand. So, check, raise, bluff. What, queen 4-4? Like, when he's calling, it's definitely more dangerous when he's, not. but yes, I'll try to bluff him out of the king high. Holy shit, he's calling with king high. Wow, okay. I guess I won't be bluffing against him. Check raise bluff. A queen 4-4 flop and then barrel turn on river. If hold the manager is gonna came back, and it did. But that was interesting hand. He called me with a king high. God damn, man. Maybe he's so used of bluffing against guys that he actually he's actually gonna be like a loose really loose when calling down. And I was check calling the river even if that 9 wouldn't hit, to be honest. But he's not betting. Oh, he had a pretty good hand, 8s. I would check calling anyway, to be honest. Would be kind of afraid of. I was definitely afraid of that 6 on the turn. Just call. I'm not gonna raise. I don't think there's any need. I mean, I could. I'll protect my hand, of course, but. Check, check, check. I don't think I'm gonna have the best hand, to be honest, unless I play against. I want to say pair of 9s, but I guess pair of 4s are gonna be fine as well. That 10 is... Wow, he actually had ace and just chip behind. Well, thank you for giving me a free look to the showdown. Hey, Dubris is here. Welcome, Dubris, to the tables. Or maybe I was the one who sat down. I don't remember. I just got lucky against you, I assume. You won't really like that one, right? You won't like that one. Oh no, I'm here the whole time. Okay, you hit king, so definitely got lucky there. Nah, not gonna defend. Tomorrow is the $1 million free already, so I definitely need to play today. The satellite. Mm-hmm. 10-8. I'll definitely raise, even though I don't think nobody of these two guys are gonna fold here. Nope, of course not. Maybe on the flop. I guess I'll bet, but I wouldn't bet that they will fold. I guess then we don't need to fold every time, but at least some portion of the time. And one did fold. I did get a 3 here, so now I'm kind of hoping GG goes for some weird raise or something. Nope, he didn't have anything this time. Can I bluff against Alex? Let's do it. He actually folds. Nice! He folds. He brought for 3 deuce of diamonds. What I mean, he had, oh, not 3 deuce, like 4 deuce is a straight, I don't know, something. I want to say that he actually folded the worst hand, but I don't know. So this table was way better than before, right? I think that's what I remember. Only Bailey. Oh, right, Diamond was here. Diamond was here. Sounds like, well, someone write it down on somewhere. So he actually raised me there, Alex. I guess I'll call down and just pay him up. I'll pay him up whatever he has. That 9 is not the greatest. If I was ahead against that 9, now I'm behind. Wow, he's actually capable of bluffing or just raising pretty with a thin value. I have no idea what he had, like a pair of 7s, a7. Oh, he did actually have a7. So that's pretty aggressive for a player like Alex, who seems obviously like a loose passive. He had 3 bets again, so maybe he's a little bit tilted now. Run a flush, not a bad result. Even though I might even be ahead here before. Wow. So I'm losing to what? I'm actually gonna cap here. I'm losing to a flush as well. That's fine, I'm gonna cap. I'm gonna lose $2 more if I'm behind. I mean, he has like, I don't know, he's waiting, I guess. He doesn't have the best hand. I'm not gonna fold again against here, these guys. GG actually, that did actually bet here, but I don't want to fold the king high. I'll call, that's fine. He actually had a 9, nice hand. So Alex raised play flop, and now he actually checks the turn. Okay. That queen, not sure if it does anything for me, so I'll fold. So I guess he had like an ace queen and actually made a fold there on the river. That's pretty strong if he actually made it. Of course I got lucky. I was just willing to call down, of course, with that 9. Wouldn't do anything crazy. It's how I'm gonna fold. Only Alex here, so Greco actually quits after that win, so maybe he was just that satisfied with that hand that he said, that's enough. Enough for this table. $70, he actually made a nice profit in today here. So when I came to the tables, he had $40 and he left with 30. With 30 profit, so $70 at the end. Nice. Good for him. Let's see the flop with 10-8 suited. Not the worst flop for my hand. I'm gonna go for check call once. And probably not gonna call again. I mean, maybe if I'm gonna be a complete reaction here, if you catch bets and he calls, I'm gonna call again, and that's even better actually. Just seeing the rear for free, didn't hit, so naturally just folding. I could even race here. I wouldn't, the race wouldn't even be that bad, even though the Matsuo, well, I know, he wouldn't have fold the fives, of course. He didn't fold a king high before, but I think I could get a Yukachi here to fold if he actually made a check behind there on the turn. I think I could make him fold ace king definitely, but yeah, I don't think Matsuo is gonna fold anything when he's gonna bet. I mean, when he's bluffing like on the flop with check raise and stuff like this, but not like this, not like this. Oops. I'm gonna raise by Alex. I'm actually gonna dong bet out here. I actually did it, nice. People fold against my 3-4. Oh yeah. Presionación! Yes. Putting pressure. if anyone is here listening right now, I don't think presionación means pressure, by the way, just putting it out there. I just like the word, even though whatever it means. I don't even know what it means. I guess something like presionation. Svetlo figured it out, but I don't even know what it is. So he actually 3-bets with 5-6 and just check behind the river. Nice. I would fold the ace-10, by the way, in the river 3-bets again. I didn't know he's capable of doing stuff like this with 5-6 suited. With the 4 PM stream starts, it's actually less like you will meet fish starter tables. I don't know, he was here with the 4, I mean, like, I see lots of Chinese people, Chinese players, who actually playing, like, when I'm playing at 4 PM. So I don't know, they're just playing, like, throughout the night or something, I don't know. That's gonna be interesting. Wow, he went down bets. And I wanted to say, if Tsui raise, bets, I'm gonna raise him and just, I don't know, put him all in on the turn or something. Wow, holy shit. Now I have to dunk bet. And bet again. Question is if I'm gonna fold if he raises. I have no idea. He never folded a king here or something. So he had to dunk bet with like total air or something. I don't know. GG Matsuo 3-bets. I'm gonna fold. I believe he's 3-bet. He's 3-betting range. I don't believe he's check raising or dunk betting the flop range, but 3-betting the pre-flop is a different story. I don't want to really fold against Cool Bananas. He did open up from the cutoff. Let's see the river. Oh, definitely calling now. Okay, that's nice. Cool Bananas playing pretty well. He's unknown. He was unknown of the, at the start of this session, but he's playing well. We haven't seen him anything too crazy about him so far, right? I don't think I have. So now I have no go here as well on these tables. Nice. Ace 4. Alex, if I raise here, he has 4.38. I'm not gonna be all in on the flop, so let's just wait. I am even willing to fold, guys. Yeah, I was obviously thinking of putting him all in, but I'm fine with a folder. I'm fine. Let him be for another round or something. He lost 41 bucks. Pretty stable. Well, 2-pair again against GG Matsuo. I assume he's gonna just fold right away. Okay. That was a little bit too fast. Lots of 2-pairs today, but no quads. No quads today, guys. I haven't seen any quads on either of these tables or, yeah. So PokerStars is still leaving something well, to be desired here. Well, there is quads. Whoever gets quads. Oh, and Rooney, thank you for the follow. I didn't see you before. Sorry about that. I'm not even sure if you guys want any shoutouts, but here I am making it one. Making it one anyway. 3-4, and I'm gonna fold. She or he or she seems to be... Oh, he's not she, that's a movie character or whatever. Yeah, I'm gonna raise right away. I'm trying to kick Matsula out, even though... Yeah, I'm just gonna raise here. Yeah, for example, his friend, yeah. His friend. Rolf, open raising capping. And he has open raising capping match, I guess. Okay. I assume when people are gonna open raising cap, they're gonna have a strong capping range. They're not gonna be doing this with a weaker hands, I assume. I think my sixes are still gonna be good here. I'm gonna make a value bet, hoping that he calls me with some ace high, because he would think that I'm... oh, he hit a 9. God damn it. He did it with a king 9. Well, obviously, I was hoping that he would be calling me here down, because he would think that I was raising with some sort of a draw. And no draw that came in, like no straight draw, no flush draw. But that 9, meh. That was a bit unfortunate. Even a king 9. I guess I would understand ace 9, but king 9 is a little bit tough to swallow, I guess. Because I would do it with a 10, of course, as well. I'm gonna keep on betting my top pairs. I'm gonna raise here unless Villagra raises instead. Obviously, I want to just. I just raised GG Matsula here. And you catch, he's actually folding lots of flops. I mean, lots of blinds, not lots of, but 38%. Which is kind of standard, but maybe the whole yellow color tech doesn't really suit him that well. When I see yellow color tech, I always think that someone is going to be like really loose and really aggressive, but maybe he's not like that. Yeah, I think I can actually raise here with my 10. I don't think he did it with a. I actually can check behind. I like check behind now. I'm losing to some tens here, so I'm gonna check behind and see what he has. And that is like perfect. I was hoping he would be bluffing, so I charge him on the turn and check behind the river instead. Just in case he actually has a better 10, I think that was perfect. Just charge him if he's like bluffing or drawing thin, and while checking behind and losing basically the same amount if he was ahead the whole time. I guess it wouldn't work if he would actually have exactly a 4 there, or whatever it was. Yeah, 4, that obviously my plan wouldn't work in that case, but I think that was pretty nice. It was pretty nice. So check by GG. If he calls, I'm just gonna check behind. I'm gonna just check behind the turn. I'm gonna wait a few seconds, so he's gonna think I'm like really weak or something, and I'm gonna call. And he has a jack as well, and we're gonna split, right? I think it was double, yeah, it was a pair board. Kings, I'm gonna fast play because of Alex. Jacks, nice. Oof, that is a bad turn, holy shit. I'm gonna bet off anyway, even though it's definitely bad. I mean, if I wasn't behind on the flop, that one is definitely a harsh one. But I guess soon Deha is just calling. Maybe he has ace queen. Like exactly ace queen. No idea what he folded there. Maybe pair of nines. Freaky weirdo. I'm gonna obviously check raise and fold against Jeffrey. I don't know. Maybe with a flush draw I shouldn't fold that quick, but I think it's not that bad. I'm gonna call. I guess when he plays like this, he has like some sort of a, I'm gonna say a fairly good showdown on my hand, but he doesn't want to see, he wants to charge me if I had a flush draw. He also could do this with a raise high and just check behind the turn when he hits the nuts. I could also see that. Quads, guys! Yes, I knew it! 9 times out of 10! Wow. 9 times out of 10, less 10 live streams. Holy shit. Again, I got quads. I mean, I didn't get quads 9 times out of less 10, but at least I saw one on either tables. But yeah, that's crazy. I got quads again. Holy shit. I wouldn't mind a check behind here. Let's do a check behind, let's see what these guys will do. I like it. I like my play. Alec just folds out of turn, so let's call here and... Wow, okay, I don't like my play anymore. But I guess the end would be the same, he wouldn't fold at 7. Obviously, till the rerun, he would actually check raise meter. I mean, he wouldn't because I would check behind, but meh. Meh. But I think we're still the right decision. If he's opening up, I guess if he's opening up queen 7 suited out of the on the gun, I shouldn't play like this, to be honest. I should just bet the flop. That's interesting. Turn and river. I mean, the turn was obviously fine, but river was something else. Oh, he's calling with ace queen. That definitely was a mistake. I'm checking behind the king now. Now I know, and just quit the table because, well, it was falling apart. Let's see if anyone is new in the home games. Yes, we have some new players. Kniz from Slovenia. Accept. Welcome, Kniz. Here's an ace again. God damn it. If it's not an ace, I guess, like, runner, or not runner, I guess another set, like, trips on the river wins, but if it's not trips on the river, I guess it's an ace, but I should stop complaining now that I just hit the nuts here. I assume I got lucky here. He actually had an ace. RJF. And hit it. Okay, we've got to stop complaining. Wow. Wow. Holy shit, what kind of tables are here? Just look at these tables, guys. I just joined waiting on three tables. One here. Damn. Like, either seat works fine for me. This is one table. This is the second table that I joined. Pretty nice as well. And this is the third one. I just need to get a seat now. Let's see the flop with 6-4 against 4 players. Why not? I guess 3. It's 4-way. Chris is back and here are quads. Let's fold now. Shouldn't play like this. This is better. Ace 9 against Dubris. I have to do it. I think he's opening up enough for the middle position, just according to the stats here. He's opening, Dubris is opening kind of a lot from middle and cutoff. It doesn't seem to be opening enough from the bottom, of course. I mean, we played 1.9k hands together, so check raise definitely doesn't do great on a board like this. My kicker definitely suffers here, so I guess an 8 or a 4 would be pretty good on the river. And here it is. Hoping for a split now. A few checks. I don't think I should be betting less. I don't know. Oh, fours. Okay. That's fine as well. Nice game, Dubris. Oh, I got a seat on the table that I was hoping for. Well, on one of the tables. Nice. Let's play three tables again. Pray. Yeah, let's pray. By the way, I have a question. I have ticket to ride for Sunday, but I was thinking I have two tournaments in the lights with good chance to get, but if I would contact them, maybe it catch to get a deal to get tournament. First, you can't make a deal from PokerStars, so you can either register the tournaments and just then unreg them, and you get tournament. You get tournament ticket and you can tournament dollars and you can sell them. I don't know, because it's a re-entry, so not sure how that works. I don't think it actually works that way. Because it's a re-entry, you can't get more tickets. I don't know if that's actually true or not. If you're considering playing the free roll, don't do that. But if you're considering playing Spin and Ghost, I guess you could try. But yeah. Raised by Yukach, and now Battery times, and even GG calls, even though that doesn't, his call doesn't mean anything. He could call with ace high, the worst ace high that I have here, but I'll fold anyway. Okay, the same ace queen actually, not a worse one, the same. You know, guys, I'm probably not gonna play that long anymore. If I'm gonna play the spin and go, or the sit and go, maybe I could even fire it up right away. Because, well, that one actually goes for 1 hour if I... You know what, I'm actually gonna... I can play 2 tables and 1 table of spin and go. Let's do that, yeah. Why not? Unless this table is really good, and it's not. Yeah, I think that's actually cool. Do I have a satellite? Oh, I do have, of course. Go here. This one? Yes, let's register. Maybe, just maybe if I...